Let's look at how we configure IP addresses in a virtual machine running on Azure. Now there's two real variations to this. Well, a couple more of you, depending on how you look at it. We have public IPs and internal private IPs. The public IPs are the ones that you can use to access the VM from the internet. And the internal IPs are the IPs that Azure assigns itself. And in both cases, they can be static or dynamic. So to begin, I've already deployed a VM. It's the simplest place to start. And I've essentially taken all the defaults. So what it's created is a network interface and a public IP address configuration. The public IP configuration is always optional. You can have a VM in Azure with no public IP. Now, if that's the case and you want to access that VM, you need to use a jump box of some sort. So you need some endpoint in Azure that you can connect to externally, and from that endpoint, you can then connect to your VM. It's pretty common if you've got a larger infrastructure deployment to have maybe one or two boxes that have public IPs for the purpose of doing administration. So a box you can RDP to, and then from there access other systems inside the implementation versus giving everything a public IP. So IP configuration is not managed internally in the VM itself. IP configuration is managed on the network interface that's managed in Azure. So here's the network interface. On the network interface, I have IP configurations. And so I can modify them from here. So right now, this VM was set to use a dynamic private internal IP address. And so what that's going to do is essentially grab the addresses from within the Azure VNet. So I've defined a VNet, and I'll just back up for a second. So we've defined a VNet for this particular VM. So here's the virtual network that it's on, and it's only got one subnet. That subnet is called default. And the network interface is connected to that subnet. You can see the IP range of the subnet. So we'll go back to our NIC. And we'll look at our IP configurations. And we can see that this particular IP configuration, it's attached to that subnet called default. And it's dynamic, so it's going to grab the first available IP on that subnet. If we want a static IP, this is how we set it. Let's say I want this one to be .10. I'm going to set it using the IP configuration that's stored in Azure. And so it's going to go ahead and save that. Now, this is a disruptive operation. So if you're going to make changes such as this, you've got to reprovision the network interface. The result of that, you're going to see a network interruption inside the VM. So it's something you want to plan accordingly. But that's how you switch from a static to a dynamic address. The best practice within Azure is to manage your subnets separately. So if you have some VMs that you want to have static addresses, some that you want to have dynamic addresses, you create a subnet for static IPs, a subnet for dynamic IPs, and you assign the VMs accordingly. Routing is completely automatic. You never have to worry about your default gateway. All you've got to worry about is the IP addresses. So some can be static, some can be dynamic. Any given interface can then be assigned a public IP. Now, a public IP is a separate object that you create. So here I've got a public IP address object. And so its configuration tells me this is a dynamic public IP. It's got a timeout, and this is where I configure the DNS name for that IP address. And this is a publicly accessible DNS name. The domain for the public IP is automatically generated. We just have to assign a host name. So something like server1cjh. I'm going to hit tab. It'll tell me if it's available or not. And if it is, and I save it, I've now created a host record I can use for that public IP. I can then assign that public IP to any interface, and it makes that interface available over that particular public IP address. It doesn't set the public IP on the virtual machine. It merely exposes that particular interface using this public IP, and in the case, this public DNS name that I've configured. And to set the public IP on the interface, it's just a matter of going to any given IP configuration and then assigning a public IP address. So I click on the configuration and then assign a public IP if I want. If I disable this, then there's no public IP and there's no way to access this particular virtual machine from the internet outside of using a jump box. So if you had a multi-tier application, for example, maybe the web servers will have the public IPs or the load balancer will have the public IPs, but the internal web application data layers would not have public IPs. We can add additional IPs. We'll just let this save. And now you can see that I have a second IP address on this interface. So again, the important point here is that at no point did I go into the virtual machine to configure the public or the IP addresses. IP address assignment and management is done within the Azure portal on the interfaces of the virtual machine. You do not want to go in and use tools like ipconfig or the network control panel or any of the available tools in Linux, the ifconfig tools, to set IP addresses. You set the IP addresses within Azure itself. Now, in terms of DNS, you can configure DNS servers two different ways. I can set the DNS on the interface itself, such as this, for example. Or I can also set that exact same value on the virtual network, and any interfaces on that network will simply inherit the DNS settings. So you can see that value right here. And if I go back to my network interface, I should say go back to my virtual network, I can set those DNS values here as well. So I'll set it to 8.8.8.8, and then I can override that on any given network interface. The thing you will not set anywhere in this entire process is a default gateway. The default gateways are completely managed by Azure. So a little bit of a shift in thinking from your traditional data center. Traditionally, you'll manage it on the operating system itself. Within Azure, whether it's static or dynamic, it's always managed in the Azure portal.